Hey, what is going on, everybody? My name is Ryan, but you can call me Yoli, and today I am bringing you guys a commentary over here on Carnage Swifty's channel. So obviously, the gameplay in the background today was done by Carnage Swifty. What you're watching is a double nuke on the map Underpass, playing a little bit of Modern Warfare 2, and he is using that trusty-dusty ACR, so I do really hope you guys enjoy that gameplay in the background, but you guys are probably wondering who I am. So like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, my name is Ryan, but I go by Yoli on YouTube, and I'm a good friend of Carnage Swifty's. I'm actually in Carnage as well, but I'm a commentator. I'm not really good at this whole gameplay thing, that's why I'm a commentator. I'm good at talking over things, and we're both in the same clan. We just kind of met up, and we're really good friends. I have done a commentary on this channel before, actually, and that was a while back, and you guys really enjoyed that, and Swifty decided to let me do another commentary on his channel, so I do really want to thank him for that, and I wanted to thank you guys for giving me the support that you gave me on a previous video that I did over on this channel. So I'm going to be getting right into this little story that I have for you guys, but first, I would like to apologize if you guys hear a little bit of a buzzing noise in the background, and that is just my air conditioner going off because it's really hot here and you got to keep it on, because if not, I'll just be sweating buckets. But I know you can hear it a bit, but hopefully it's not too noticeable, and hopefully you guys don't hate on me too much for that. But I'm going to be getting right into the story of how me and my friends caught a robber. So this took way back 2 years ago, maybe even 1 year ago. And me and my friends were going on a trip to Toronto for a business trip. And if you guys have been to Toronto or you live near Toronto, then you'll probably know where the Eaton Centre is. So we went to the Eaton Centre. And if you guys don't know what that is, it's basically a huge mall that they have in Toronto. And when I say huge, I'm not kidding. This mall is like, it's huge. I don't know how else to explain it. So we went there for a business trip to learn about the different businesses. But obviously, that's just an excuse to get out of school. We didn't really learn about businesses. We just kind of went shopping. But it was around lunchtime, and I was getting pretty thirsty, so I wanted to go to a Booster Juice or an Orange Julius or something like that. I couldn't exactly remember which one we went to, but I think it was an Orange Julius. And I was waiting in line there, you know, I was getting like a smoothie or a juice or whatever. I can't really remember what I had, like I mentioned. And me and my friend were just waiting in line. I don't think he was getting anything. And this old man comes up to us, and he has his phone in his hand. It's one of those flip phones from way back in the day, and it had a little scratch on it. It didn't look like it was huge, but it did have a little scratch on it. And he comes up to us. He's like, "Hey guys, I just dropped my phone, and I'm gonna need some money for the payphone. Can you donate a little bit of money?" And then we're like, "All right." Being the nice guys that we were, we gave him like $2 each for the payphone, and that's like $4. So, $4 for a payphone, that must be one good payphone. Must get like Wi-Fi or something on that thing. But yeah, so we gave him the money and we didn't really think much of it. So after that, we just kind of wandered around and we reunited with some of our other friends who were also on that field trip. So there was probably a big group of around 6 or 7 people, and we're just kind of wandering around the mall. And we saw this guy again, and he was doing the same thing. You know, he was asking people for money, and he was using the excuse that his phone was broken. That's when we started to get a bit fishy, because we're like, "Hey, we already gave this guy money for the payphone, why would he have to use it again?" So we started following him around for a bit, and it turns out he was asking like nearly every single person in the mall for money. He's just wandering around to like each side, you know, going back and forth so it's not too obvious. But he was asking a lot of people for money, and he must have made a lot of money, because he was asking for like $2 from each person, and he asked a lot of people, and a lot of people actually gave him money. So we're like, "Hey, this isn't right, so we should probably go approach him or something." So my big group of 6 or 7 friends, we walked up to this guy and we're like, "Hey man, we already gave you money to use the payphone. What are you doing with all this extra money?" And he's like, "Oh, you know, it's not what it looks like. I'm not gonna use this money to buy drugs or alcohol or anything like that. I'm actually using this money to donate to charity." And this guy does not look like one of those people who would lie to donate money to charity. He was old, he had, you know, a huge beard, he looked really, he didn't look homeless, because like he had a telephone, he had some like nice clothes on, so he definitely wasn't homeless, but he just looked really creepy, and he was having all this money, and I guarantee he wasn't donating that money to charity. So we're like, "Alright, we're not gonna go get security at all." And we actually didn't end up getting security, because we had to go back to school and do all that kind of stuff. But that is a story about how me and my friends kind of caught a robber. I know it's not really as exciting as it may seem in the title, but I still thought it was a pretty interesting story that I would share with you guys. So anyways, if you guys did enjoy the story, then feel free to check out my link. That will be in the description below. I'm getting so close to 500 subscribers, I can almost taste it. And if you really enjoyed the video, feel free to leave a like on this video. I'm sure that would really mean a lot to Swifty. And yeah, thank you once again, and I'll see you guys later. I'm out. Peace.